Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest notifications.
Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the repo rate cut by RBI in the first bi-monthly monetary policy of the financial year 20. So the video is about how the repo rate cut has affected the economy, what was expected from this monthly policy, and how much the expectations are fulfilled. We are going to discuss on all these topics in a brief manner, which can help you in your government exams. RBI has decided to cut the policy repo rate under liquidity adjustment facility by 25 basis points, which brings down it from 6.25% to 6%. Now, repo rate is the rate at which the central bank of the country lends money to the commercial banks. So now we'll analyze this news and how this affects our economy. But before moving forward, there is also another important announcement which is equally relevant for us to know. That is, RBI continues to maintain neutral stance in its monetary policy. So RBI has clearly stated that it will continue to have neutral stance. That is, it will not change as speculated by many newspaper experts and journalists. Some other figures which you must know are, first, repo rate, reverse repo rate has been fixed at 5.75% and marginal standing facility rate is 6.25%. Now, reasons behind RBI's decision. So why RBI chose to do what it did? First was that GDP growth fall from 7.2% to 7%. So the GDP of the country, which is gross domestic product, was falling. The probable reasons as per the circular or the release by RBI could be classified into two ways. One is domestic and the other is international. Second factor was the inflation was below 4%. The inflation was within the expected target of the country or the authorities. So we had a good buffer to deal with. Now, talking about the domestic factors, the reasons why RBI decided to cut the repo rate. So on the demand side, low public-private expenditure. Because of this, the inflation was going down. The next point is high gross fixed capital formation. Now, you must be thinking that just now I told you that expenditure by public or private expenditure was going down. Then how come capital formation was rising? The rise was very small and the rise was solely because the government was spending more and more. Third is low growth in import and high exports. That is, the growth in terms of import. Again, we told you that the demand was low, so the imports were low while the exports was higher. Also, the supply side didn't show very good impact as the growth of real gross value added by agriculture sector was on a decline. So agriculture sector didn't contribute as much to the gross value added by it as it used to in the previous years. So overall, it impacted the GDP. Now, international factors. The international factors or the international front which actually contributed to the decline or the cut in the repo rate was, first, uncertainty in the world economy. Now, world economy, I mean what happens in other countries. Recently, the UK also economy also was on a low point because there was high tensions among the country's internal politics regarding Brexit, which affected the country's output. Also, countries like China, Brazil are good example of what is happening now in India, because these countries have been and are also going through a similar phase of low demand both on national as well as international fronts, because of which their GDP is going down, and India is also now starting to face a similar situation. Next is US-China trade war. So US and China are actually going on a trade war, and the trade war between these two superpowers is actually going to affect other economies also. So probably this also was a big reason why RBI felt the need to actually infuse money in the market so that the demand by the consumer for the goods increases. And as a result, the economy could grow. Next is rise in price of crude oil prices. Now, crude oil prices are rising because there is a conflict going on between Qatar and the OPEC, which you all must be knowing. So because of this, the prices of oil are also going to rise in future. And because of this, the inflation or the demand on other goods might be affected. So this was also a prominent reason. Now, okay, we understood that RBI, because of certain domestic and international factors, considering the fact that inflation was lower than expected and hence we had a buffer zone, decided to reduce the lending rate, which would actually give people access to more money. So more and more people would go to the bank, borrow the money and use that money or spend that money on goods and services, which will eventually lead to price rise or inflation. That could be a problem, but considering that we have we are well below the expected level, we can actually afford a certain kind of price rise. So the government has moved in that way. But what can be the impact on the macroeconomic level? First is banks are going to face a big problem. What problem am I talking about? You can see banks have high credit but low deposit. What this means, I'll just tell you. They will have high creditors. That is basically the low lending rates encourages bank to lend. So as soon as there is low lending rate, banks will have a chance to increase their lending by offering the money at a lower rate. Since the repo rate is less, they can provide money at a lower rate to the public. So public will start taking loan. This will increase the supply of money in the market and the money circulation increases. Also, it is expected that the EMI, that is those people who are already have taken loan, will have to pay less of their EMIs. So this is also a good news. But however, the cross shows that there is also certain kind of problem associated with it. First problem is credit need funds with bank. That is, when you go to a bank, so you need loan. But what if the bank says they don't have money to give you loan? The reason being because we know that banks give loan from the money which public deposits in their deposits. So if a bank is low on deposits, it cannot provide loan to the public no matter what the interest rate on the lending be. So if there are no money in the bank, then they are not able to in fact give you loan. When the interest rates or the rate has fallen, then the people who have deposited money might feel that they could have invested somewhere else instead of going to bank. So those deposits which they have invested, they might withdraw that. Because of this withdrawal, banks would be low on fund. So if they are low on fund, they cannot actually lend it to someone because they don't have money to actually lend it to the borrowers. So despite of lower interest rate, they are not able to lend to the public. Second problem is similar to what the first one was, low investment. So because they had low deposit, they won't invest in mutual funds. So mutual fund market, which was a good market to invest in and was used to earn profit by these banks, now since they don't have deposit, they won't invest in mutual funds, which in a way would affect the financial markets of the country also. So it might have a wrong impact on the financial markets. Second impact would be make bond transactions profitable. Now, what do you mean by bond transaction? How are they profitable? I'll tell you. Bond transactions are profitable because there's a simple mathematics behind it. How? Just see this. We just take a hypothetical example where P is the value, Y is the interest received by the holder. Now, when the price of the bond is inversely proportional to yield. That is, when the yield increases, price falls, and while yield falls, price increases. So when there is lower rate of lending, which is when there is lower yield, because of this, there is increase in the price of bonds. So when there is lower yield, there is increase in the price of bond, and when the price of bond rises, then those people who are holding the bonds might sell it in the market. So they actually are gaining because of this, because they can now sell the bonds which they purchased earlier at a lower rate and sell it at a higher rate, because now people are more interested in investing in bonds. Next was the criticism. Now this move is also facing a lot of criticism from the experts. What kind of criticism? Prominently, two criticisms have come in front. First is liquidity is low in the system. Simply putting repo rate down will not solve the problem. Yes, just by reducing the repo rate, there won't be a solution, because by reducing the lending rate, we just discussed that lending might not be a major solution to the problem. So there need to be some other advancement also to substantiate with this. A simple and one solution to this problem is not possible. We need more. So what could be the other solution? Open market operations. In past few years, the open market operations have come across phenomenally well. They have performed well in determining the market condition and also keeping a check on inflation. Second was, stance should be changed from neutral to accommodated by RBI to boost growth and liquidity. Now, stance, what does this mean? Recently, RBI came to neutral stance. So what does neutral stance mean? Neutral stance basically means a state of equilibrium. So the government, instead of interfering in the market, is ready to be on an equilibrium and watches the market to function on its own. So government, instead of considering the fact that the inflation is low and the money needs to be pumped in the market, should have adjusted to accommodative stance, in which the government actually intervenes in the market and tries to boost the economy by increasing the money supply in the market. So when the RBI or the government actually tries to intervene and increase money supply, that situation is much more favorable for our country than just sitting and watching the market to work on its own. For such enriching videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you have any queries, you can email us at successrbi@anujindal.in or contact us at 9999466225. Thank you.